Welcome to blog number 2 from Russia. Today we are heading to St. Petersburg. We are taking a train there and I'll tell you all the details about the train and everything in a bit. But for now, we need to check out, get into the cab and get to the station. Let's go. Everything here is written in Russian. It's very confusing. We've just boarded our train. This is a Sapsan train, which is basically a high-speed train, like a bullet train, that goes from Moscow to St. Petersburg. It travels with a speed of 250 kilometers per hour and covers the whole journey in 3.5 hours. Usually, it takes about 8 hours to go from Moscow to St. Petersburg. So, in terms of saving time, this is actually really cool. And the train is pretty great in the sense that it has all the amenities. It almost feels like you're in a flight. It doesn't feel like a train at all. And I'm quite excited. This is my first ever train journey in a country that's not India. So I'm very excited about it. Let's see how this experience is. So this train actually has a full dining cart as well. So sort of like a bistro car. And in that, you can come and order whatever you want to eat. So we've come here and we've ordered ourselves some blini. Blini is essentially like a Russian pancake with ham and cheese. And we've ordered that for us. It looks very good, it's hot and the view is great. Really looking forward to try this. We just reached St. Petersburg and it is frigging cold here. Like, it's really cold. But also I'm really excited to explore a new city. Let's walk. So we've just reached our room in Holiday Inn. So we are staying at Holiday Inn Theatre Square, which is a Holiday Inn property that's actually very close to almost all the important spots in Petersburg. I'm going to give you a quick room tour because this is actually a very different room from anything that I've ever stayed at. I'll show you. So this here is kind of like the overview of the room. So on this side is the bed where we'll be staying. And then on the other side, there's actually a bunk bed. On the opposite side, there's a TV, there's a table for everything. We've kept our bags here. Something that I quite like is that this actually opens to the window. Like there's a window on top and I can see the sky from there. And this here is the washroom and the toilet. There's obviously no jet spray. That's something that we have to live with. We have the cupboards. And there's a full-length mirror here as well. But the bed looks comfortable and that's all I care about. We're actually not in St. Petersburg for a lot of days. We're leaving from here day after tomorrow. So we need to make sure that we don't waste today and then step out and do stuff. Even though I'm feeling super cold outside, it's very, very cold. I think it's important that I don't take a rest day and just go out and explore. The city looks absolutely beautiful. Let's go. So our first stop in St. Petersburg is sadly a mall, which is not something that we do first thing in any city, but this place is insanely cold. So we need to buy a lot of warm jackets and stuff. And then the next place that we're going after this is even colder. So we want to be like fully packed. So we've just come here to get some jackets. But before that, I'm really hungry. So I'm going to order something to eat. I'm not sure exactly what to eat here. I don't think this mall has a lot of traditional Russian food. So we're just going to order probably like a soup or something. So I do see like a Korean stand here. So maybe I'll just order something Korean. So we are done with our shopping for all of the warm clothes that we needed. We got some really good jackets and for now we're really hungry again. I feel like we've just been constantly hungry here. It's almost dinner time, so we've come to a pub. It's called Finnegan's and it's an Irish pub here. It was very highly rated. A lot of good things I had heard about them. So I'm here, we're gonna have some Irish beer, probably some food, fish and chips, who knows.
day 2 in St. Petersburg, and today we're all set to do a lot of touristy things. We're starting our day with this canal tour. So St. Petersburg actually has a lot of canals running throughout the city. It's called the Venice of the North, I think. I don't like these labels anyway, but I am very excited about taking the river canal here, and we're getting started with that. Right, was amazing, and now we have come for lunch to this cafe called Cafe Kvartika. Not sure if I'm pronouncing it right, but it's a really beautiful Soviet cafe designed like an old Soviet apartment. Soviet history is something that has always fascinated me, so I'm here to eat some authentic Russian food in the middle of an authentic Soviet Russian apartment. The lunch is done. It was absolutely delicious, and now we are at the main spot at St. Petersburg, which is the Hermitage Museum. So this is essentially the winter palace where the family would come down and live during the winter months. The family of Peter the Great and a lot of other empires and empresses of this area. So this whole palace has been turned into a museum, and I've heard such amazing things about it. It's one of the biggest museums in the whole world, and this place is really nice. It's absolutely beautiful. The only problem is that it's freezing right now. It's raining constantly, and it is just, it's too cold. But I'm excited to go inside. Let's go. You know, they say this museum is so big that if you stop by every single painting and article that is there in this museum for 1 minute, then it'll take you 11 years to complete this whole place. It's absolutely crazy. Hi, it's the next day. So last night after the museum, which was so long, by the way, it took us like 2-ish hours to go through the whole thing. We decided to simply go for dinner, and we actually went to a really nice restaurant. It was called Kazan Mangal, and we had some Uzbeki and Georgian food. I had never had Uzbeki or Georgian food in my life, and it was so delicious. Like, life update, it's one of my absolute favorite cuisines now. So good. The food was amazing. The restaurant was really good. So if you do come to St. Petersburg, make sure that you try out that restaurant. It was very good. But yeah, for now, St. Petersburg is coming to an end. I know our trip here was really short, especially in this city, because we want to go to the next destination and spend enough time there. So we had to compromise on St. P a little bit. So yeah, for now, I'm just going to go ahead and pack my clothes and also pack myself, because the place we are heading to now is even colder than St. Petersburg, which is saying something, because I'm already like freaking freezing here. But yeah, I'm supposed to pack everything and then leave for Murmansk, which is the northernmost point that we are hitting in Russia, and this point is actually above the North Pole, like above the Arctic Circle. And I'm just like, and this point is actually above the Arctic Circle, so you can imagine how cold it's going to be. It's already showing 0 degrees there, so I'm like freaking out. But let's go. It's going to be a journey of a lifetime, taking a flight in a different country while traveling like in between the country itself is not something I've done. I'm really looking forward to it. I'll see you in the next vlog from Murmansk. I hope you'll enjoy this one, and I hope that you enjoy the next one as well. I'll see you next time. Bye.